Hey guys, it is Mike from Baltimore Rides here, September 6th. It's a Wednesday, but really this is a wrap-up video for my Tuesday night. And honestly, guys, pretty good evening. I'm pretty pleased with the evening. Finishing the night at 115, at basically $150 even. It was like a little bit more than that. It's 150 and loose change, but you know, call it 150 flat. And I got started down in DC at like 4 o'clock, 4:15 by the time I got down with traffic on 95. You know, so from 4 o'clock to 1 o'clock, let's call it, you know, that's not a bad night on a Tuesday. 20 trips, so I'm more than two-thirds of the way done with my quest goal for the Monday through Thursday. So that's another huge accomplishment. I have to do 28 trips. I had one under my belt from yesterday and then 20 today. So I've got 7 more to go for an extra $90 quick. And then I'm sure there'll be a Friday, Saturday, Sunday quest that they'll add on at a later date. So, you know, I'm playing with the phone mount, guys. Sorry. But you know, that's kind of how this whole thing works, is that they do a Monday through Thursday quest and then they do a weekend quest. And you know, honestly, between the two of them, if they do both, I can do really well. And that's kind of what I'm hoping for, is that they're consistent about both and I can make $100 to $150 a week in just doing what I'm already doing. You know, and that's the honest to goodness truth of the matter, is that it's not really any rocket science. Instead of driving at the airport and hoping and praying for the right number of trips to get me to 150 to 200, on a Tuesday night, I did $200 in less time than I would have had I, you know, fought for it at the airport. At the airport, I'd be out till 2-3 in the morning sometimes to get 150 on a weeknight. And you know, honestly, I could probably keep going for another hour, but I'm not going to. You know, this is my Monday through Thursday goal, is 150. I feel like yesterday's 60 or whatever it was, 70 something bucks is like freebie money towards that goal, because I really worked a half day. And you know, that's fine. If I can get to where I need to be, you know, with 150 a night without having to kill myself Monday through Thursday, that's phenomenal. I'm really, really happy with that. So I am, you know, I got an hour ride home because I'm all the way down in DC. I'm in Georgetown right now. And, you know, that's that. Ironically, and this is more for humor than anything else, I pulled into a gas station after my last trip to get my bearings, just because I wanted to pull up my nav system and, you know, pull up my home address and see which route it was taking me. And I look up and there's the brick staircase from The Exorcist. And I Googled it just to be sure that I wasn't, you know, screwed up in the head, because there's lots of stone staircases in Georgetown. But no, 3600 Prospect is the address of the haunted house in The Exorcist. And lo and behold, I was sitting at the gas station that's at the bottom of that staircase. So that's pretty entertaining. It doesn't mean anything. It has nothing to do with Uber. But if ever you're in Georgetown, check it out. It's real creepy. There's no house at the bottom of that staircase, just so you know. There's a gas station and then just a stone wall. And at the top of that staircase is an old building that used to be like a trolley facility. There's all sorts of lore around that building, but it burned down at some point after the filming of the movie, and you know, people claimed it was haunted and all this other stuff. If you believe in ghosts, you're you know, you can dig into it more. I happen to believe in that kind of stuff, but if you don't, then it's just mumbo jumbo. Whatever way you go on that coin is your business. But it burned down, and the city, out of I guess respect for whatever, didn't put another house there. They eminent domained the property and built a trolley garage there, believe it or not. And the trolley garage then burned down some years later, And then they built a second one and just basically left it empty. So it was like an empty building. So it's had a very, you know, mysterious past, that particular site, ever since the movie was filmed in the whatever it is. I guess it's the 70s when that movie was made. It might be the 80s. I'm not sure. I just know that movie was creepy beyond all belief, and it creeped me the hell out, and it still does when I watch it, but I love it. So, okay, that's enough about that. It's random, but I thought it was kind of curious that I ended up there. You know, I had a good night tonight, guys. I'm not going to lie. I really did. No bad customers, no drama. I did go to Reagan several times. I want to say 5 trips out of Reagan. And, you know, honestly, they're all short trips. They're all $10 or less. I did get one that took me out a little bit further. And then I actually had a couple longer trips that took me into Virginia just from the city. I think people going home from work. There was rain, and there was definitely some surge around that. Although, ironically, I learned a little secret, guys, and I will share this with you. For those of you that are doing Uber Eats delivery, you know, food delivery, when you know there's rain coming, turn off Uber Eats. Because Uber Eats does not get surge pricing. And when it's dinner time and pouring rain, a lot of people order takeout or order delivery. So you're going to screw yourself because there's going to be a surge cloud of people trying to get a ride in the rain, and you're going to be delivering food and paying, you know, getting regular fare price for your deliveries instead of surge pricing. So just turn off your delivery for a few minutes while there's a rain surge cloud so you don't screw yourself. I'm just sorry, I'm talking slow. I'm just making sure I don't miss the turn. Because it's raining and dark. I'm on Claire Burton Parkway to 495. So just an FYI there. I learned that tonight. I was a little frustrated when I saw that when I went and looked back at a couple of my Uber Eats trips. I did a bunch of them in that Georgetown area. You know, there's a lot of little restaurants around there. Okay. And sorry, I'm listening to directions in my earpiece. But, you know, that's a good place to do Uber Eats, and I'm actually pretty excited about that little spot because it's tucked away, and I don't think people realize how many little delivery places are down there. And also Georgetown College is there, which is an awful campus to deliver on. I'm just going to warn you guys now, it is a nightmare to navigate that campus. And those particular passengers are fussy. So I ended up on some weird, like, side lot up in, like, Seton Hall or Canton Hall or some crap up on the Georgetown campus. And I literally could drive no further. And I had to call this chick and say, like, look, come get your sushi. I have no idea where you are, but I don't get out of my car unless I'm walking to a door. I don't go walking through campuses to try and find your dorm building. So, you know, I was polite about it. I didn't say it exactly like that, but I said it in that effect. So just an FYI there, when you are doing Uber Eats, don't leave your car. Don't leave your leave eyesight of your car. That's not the way that works. It's walk-up service, not walk-in service. So, you know, you walk to their door and they're supposed to meet you at the door. If you can't get to their door, you stay at your car and they come to you. I think that's very respectful and fair. But I'm not parking my car on some college campus and then getting a ticket or getting it towed while I'm trying to find some knucklehead on their dormitory. They can come to me for their sushi roll. It's not the end of the world. So that's that, guys. Great night. You know, I'm not even, right now, I'm not even feeling the need to go to BWI. I think Reagan is a great source of revenue. It's quick, and that's what I really like about it, is you don't feel the, you know, the time clock ticking over your head. You barely have time to use the restroom. And my last two trips, I didn't even park. I literally just came in and just followed the course to the exit. And by the time I got to the exit, I already had a ride. So, you know, I would love to, I'd love to say that's always how it is. There's been a couple times when I've actually not stayed at Reagan because the queue was like 60 plus and it was moving at a, you know, what I would consider normal airport pace, which to me is not what Reagan's about. You know, if I can't get in and out with Reagan in 15 minutes and have a ride request, then it's time to bug back out into the city. So that's, you know, that's basically where it is, guys. I'm going to do this again tomorrow, and, you know, Thursday I'm taking off. That's going to be my day off with my son. So he wants to go to the Cub Scouts. So we're going to go scout out and check out a Cub Scout meeting and see if it's something that interests him. And that'll be my day off this week. So, you know, that's kind of where we stand. So if I can do another 150 tomorrow, that'll put me, and plus get the boost or the quest goal, I'm sorry, you know, that'll put me somewhere in the vicinity of 450-ish, and that would be beautiful. You know, that would be beautiful. And then I think this weekend will be a strong weekend. College kids are back in town, business is returning to normal. I think it'll be a very strong weekend. So that's where we stand, guys. You know, for those of you that have been trying on BWI for size, and obviously, you know, I was talking about BWI for quite some time. I don't want you to think that I'm betraying you by not going there, but you guys have to, you know, if you've watched my older videos, you know that I'm constantly changing things up. I'm constantly trying to find the sweet spot. And this is a new hunting ground or fishing ground, if you will, that I think is gonna be more profitable. So I'm gonna try it on for size until I feel like I have enough data to really make a good determination. I feel like 2 or 3 weeks, you know, weekdays, weekends, will give me a sense of whether this is a really, really good decision or whether it's basically Baltimore, you know, or not. So we'll see. If in a month's time I feel like this is better, then I'll stick to DC. It's worth the hour commute. I was making an hour commute in my last career. So it's worth driving an hour to work in a better place, you know, and make better money, you know, for my time, than to slog it out at the airport or in Baltimore and not necessarily know if you're gonna have a good night or not. And that was kind of the consensus. I was fighting and fighting hard in Baltimore to make 150 to 200 a night. You know, and I was definitely frustrated. I was fighting the clock at BWI. Some nights were great, some nights were just terrible. So, you know, that's where I stand, is that, hey, if this is consistently these numbers down in DC, plus the quest, plus the better boost numbers, then that makes sense. It just makes sense, plain and simple. So, you know, keep an ear out. I'm going to keep reporting out and letting you know how I'm doing. And that will kind of, you know, like I said, if the fishing grounds are good, then, you know, then I will let you guys know. And we can all talk at that point about, you know, where. And I'll dial in a little bit more specifically, because I'm learning the neighborhoods as I go. So as soon as I know more, I will tell you guys. I'm still in the experimentation phase. I'm still learning my way around. I think I got zapped at a red light camera tonight. I came up to a stop, but I think my wheels went over the line, and the crosswalk line, and I think it zapped me. So, you know, I'm still frustrated with that. There's cameras galore in this area, and I feel like I may have fallen into one or two pit traps where they got me. But we'll see. We will have to just wait and see on that. You know, if that's the case and it's consistent, then that's going to cost me money. And that's something I need to factor in. So we'll see how that goes. But, you know, but that's where we stand, guys. So I'm going to let you go. I'm going to wrap it up here. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a great night, everybody.